Hello everyone and welcome back to the walkthrough sub level 4 of the subterranean complex. Begins here with dramaticness. This is a bonus floor, isn't it? Yeah! Alright. This place, the subterranean complex, is the best place to get white and purple Pikmin, by the way. So, yeah, you most certainly want to go here if you want to get your Pikmin numbers up. I should say your special Pikmin numbers up. I wonder if I should get some whites as long as I'm here. Whites are pretty nice, and you guys are stuck on that. Ivory Candy Pop Bud. And now everyone's getting stuck on the thing. And it's also a place to power up the Pikmin too, which is kind of, now that I think of it, it's kind of unfortunate that I powered up Pikmin in the last part with the... Well, I shouldn't say it's unfortunate, because I can still do so after I switch colors and whatnot, and I most certainly want to get... No. Most certainly want to get two sprays for the price of one. Come on. Do it. Do it. Good boy! Yes! Success! Alright, let's look around here. Because this is a safe floor. A safe floor that we can relax on and enjoy the sights that really are actually kind of grimy. Maybe we shouldn't stay here for too long. It's kind of gross. I wonder if I should... Because I got so many blues now, I'm wondering if I should actually trade them in for some whites. So yeah, I think that's what I'm going to do. Yeah. I think that will be perfectly fine. I don't have to worry that much about blue numbers nowadays. And I definitely want to keep my yellows, though, for certain something a little bit later on. I'll pluck those a little bit later. I just want to make sure that I get everyone plucked when I'm ready to pluck them, I guess you could say, because I want to get the whole squad full of leaves. So when I do get them all pollinated, they will be all, oh, by the way, touch these things, they'll get added to the Picklepedia. They'll be, all ready to get pollinated and, yeah, power up and whatnot, so, yeah. By the way, you're gonna, in longer dungeon, you see geysers like this too. Oh, no, Metites! Metites, this is good! This is very good! Attack them all! Attack them all! Oh, I was too late. Just like that other time, but that's okay. Don't worry, they won't knock the Pikmin off the edges or anything like that. But, you know, it's just like a scare tactic, and they're mostly there for powering Pikmin up than actually being a hindrance to you or anything like that. So, yeah. As you can tell, there isn't anything on the floor because the Pikmin are singing happily. And they should automatically start plucking these here. Yep, that's what I thought. And, oh, shoot. Didn't mean to do that. Well, there's enough nectar on this floor anyway. Leaves, get in there because you're last in line to move. Looks like everyone's powered up, I think. It looks like, yeah, I think everyone's powered up. But let's just go to this corner just to be sure. Let's get them all coagulated in here. No, get them. Man, those whites are fast when they're flowered. Yeah, it looks like we're done here. Not even any Queen Candy Pop Buds or anything like that to, power up our Pikmin. It's just a really short floor that's more of a bonus area than anything. There's going to be a similar one with purple candy pop, violet candy pop buds a little bit later on. This was the ivory candy pop bud floor. Alright, so number 4 is complete with flying colors, quite literally. oh no! This might be the most dangerous floor of the place. Okay, here's what you want to do. Put your Pikmin somewhere in the corner and grab like one white or something fast. Okay, I got some yellows in there. Okay, put the yellow there. And now we're going to grab this one, we're going to hold it, and we're going to run around the place. The reason why we want to do this is because bomb rocks can fall from the sky and oh god, and those two, these are volatile Dweevils. They are a suicide enemy that actually blows themselves up. Yeah, don't mess with them. Do not mess with them. Yeah, you don't want to be cornered by these suckers. And also, on this floor, stuff will fall out of the sky when you have a Pikmin in your party. And stuff will fall out of the sky when Pikmin are carrying stuff back to the ship. Yeah, lots and lots of explosions this floor. Okay, I got this side cleared out of falling traps for that, for holding Pikmin, I guess, in my party. And I'm gonna go around to the other corner and start clearing it out. Hopefully. And then I'm gonna come through again with Louie, you know, with the whole party all together here, and then see how things go. Oh god, oh god! This floor is not, you know, it's kind of funny. This right here usually has a treasure right here, and the exit is usually on the other side, but it generated differently this time. Okay. Alright. Now, what we're gonna do here is we're gonna throw that Pikmin over there so it's nice and safe. Switch to Louie and take our squad through here. Well, to an extent. I'm gonna... Actually, maybe what I should do is go back through here with Olimar and activate the bomb rocks along this place just so that they don't explode while we're passing by, you know, chain reactions and stuff like that. Yeah, maybe I should do that. I wasn't really thinking about that my first way through for some reason. Don't know why. I'm absolutely going to have to take Pikmin down here, which is not the most confidence-inducing of places, because as you can tell, that's a dead end. And dead ends could lead to explosive results. So yeah. Oh god, another one fell! One that I missed somehow. Let's just get these activated. Okay, and now let's get everyone together. Because at the very least, I'll have everyone to do stuff with. Now, yeah, I know there's one missing. That other one is over by the exit, so don't worry about it. I didn't see any devastation over there. Okay, now what I'm going to do here is take my whole squad of Pikmin and run through the area just to see if I can trigger some stuff. Like to fall from the sky, because they're all flowered, so they should be able to get away from any threats. Just run through, run through, run through, run through. Just to see if there's anything gonna fall. Okay. Oh, demon! Yeah, they fall when different quantities of Pikmin also come through the area as well, so that's why I wanted to run through there with squads of Pikmin. Alright, now, got another obstacle. I bet as soon as I start putting Pikmin on here, stuff is gonna start falling. Either it's because they're gonna be carrying stuff back to the base, or, yep, that's what I thought! Or it's going to be because, it's because they're digging stuff out of the ground. Okay, so that's now kinda clear. I'm not sure. And now I'm gonna put stuff on here, and see if something falls from the sky. This floor, I swear. Stop that! So many volatile Dweebles! Okay. Now, I'm gonna try and tag team this here. Got that cleared out to an extent. We're gonna listen for stuff that's gonna fall out of the sky. Whoops! Okay. Whites on these things might be a good idea because they're faster. Whoops. Because, you know, when they're faster, they can carry it through obstacles faster and less likely to explode. So I'm going to put 7 whites on here and hope they make it back. I probably should escort them, but I don't know. I'm thinking of the time. You know, walkthrough parts can get kind of lengthy if you have to keep escorting everything back. I'm pretty sure they'll be safe, though, because of their speed, so, yeah. Alright, they should be good getting back, hopefully. They're just whites, and I don't need as many whites as I need other colors, like purples. So, yeah. I should say just whites and blues. So I'm not that concerned! Notice I'm still being careful getting through these hallways, if you can call them hallways, whatever they are. Alright, there we go. Another sort of clock-like implement. Mystical disc. Okay. Careful. Everyone be careful. Everyone panic too, just in case. Cameras. Not my friend. Did they make it back yet? They should be getting really close, yeah. So I thought some of the squad's gonna get on that. Yep. And I think those Pikmin are trying to join us. What do we have? Adamantine Girdle! Okay, the floor is complete. We made it through one of the most dangerous floors in the subterranean complex. With no deaths! I call that 100% pure victory. Okay, sub-level 6. Let's do it. Last one I'm gonna do this part, most likely. Unless it goes really quickly. But I would doubt that. Okay, we got some poison over there. Good thing I got my whites powered up. I just say my whites built up. Actually, it's not that big of a deal if I only had like one white in my team, because there's not really anything that's super dangerous to what, you know, whites in general, that you absolutely have to have whites and anode beetles. Are they gonna be combined with something else? Oh, fiery dweebles. It's carrying that big bolt. Okay, I'm gonna let them do their thing while I take a look around here. And okay, you can carry that if you'd like. I don't mind if you do that. Okay. Oh, this purple Dweevil. New different kind of Dweevil. It's known as a Munge Dweevil. It's the poison kind, and there's a rather high concentration of enemies around here. This is not a very good randomly generated layout. Maybe I should focus on that a little bit later and see what's on this side here. Well, there's another Munge Dweevil. I guess I could take it out just for kicks. Well, no, actually, okay, I'll just walk off the edge. That works perfectly fine, too. It just goes off the edge. I didn't have to do anything to it. Oh, game. You know how to make me laugh. You think a critter would know better, but no. No, it doesn't. Alright, so let's just leave that guy be while I take care of these bad boys here. Yeah, there we go. Oh, no! Oh, shoot. Oh, and a purple went over. You know what? This floor sucks the way it's laid out anyway. Reset! I don't even know how Pikmin got thrown off the edge there anyway. It's like they bounced off of something. Because you notice that my first throw was right on top of the anode beetle, and I didn't move the cursor or anything like that, and they just start... Wow, this generated right by the ship. Interesting. I guess I'll grab that before Dweevil gets it. Alright. But yeah, that floor just was not friendly to me. Repair Juggernaut. I definitely want to have some yellows with me for the boss of this place. So that's why I'm kind of disappointed when I lost a bunch of yellows there by somehow throwing them off the edge. I'm not even sure how that happened. I was totally puzzled by how that... It's just like they bounce off of something, and I don't know. And don't shock them. Don't shock them. Okay, there we go. They only arc their electricity across in a straight line from stuff, and yeah. Wait, hold on. Is there anything worth... There is. I gotta take that back with yellows, probably. And I don't even have to deal with them, really. Because, you know, as long as I have the yellows, they're immune to everything, electricity-wise. So the anode beetles are completely harmless. I just hope that I don't need more than 9 of these for it. Ah, really? Well, I might be able to sneak it past with a white. Maybe. Just maybe. Because they're all coagulating over by that side, so oopsie. Maybe not. Alright, I'm getting greedy here, I admit. I could have just done this without any losses if I would have just thrown yellows on top of them. Or purples, you know, to stun them and flip them over at the same time and whatnot. But I got a little bit too hasty for my own good here. Alright, there we go. Let's just do it the proper way. I will accept that loss because it was a fault of PK Gam. And not some sort of weird throwing issue. And it wasn't necessarily a purple, so yeah. I mean, it wasn't a purple, so it's not that big of a deal. Or anything like that. Oh, come on. I want to throw them on top. Not off to... Don't... Oh, there we go. Okay. Okay, and now once I get rid of this last one, the last, I should say this one here, the last one that will be remaining will be completely harmless. They're only dangerous when they can arc electricity between each other. I mean, they can spark all they want to, but it's not powerful enough to kill other colors of Pikmin. So, yeah. Okay, I'm gonna grab those, then grab those. 13's fine. I just need to get back this oven dial. Very important that we get the oven dial. let's take a look-see around here now. Hopefully there won't be any more anode beetles. They usually like to be hung all around one particular area because, you know, they have to be together in order for the electricity to arc and whatnot. Okay. Space wave receiver. Oh, that's not an oven dial. That's a old TV dial. So I was a little bit inaccurate on that. But still, just as important as the oven dial. As I should say, as an oven dial would be. Creening Dirigibug. That's gonna try and blow stuff up. Yep. And oh, there's another one there too. Well, that's lovely. Hopefully there isn't a something in there. You know, like, one is carrying something. Like a treasure or something like that, because that would really suck. Okay, I'm gonna take a look. Well, you've got something. This is difficult. Because the way that they're set up is they're going over the they're going over the holes, I guess you could say, you know, the bottomless pit areas, and that's not good because I can't throw Pikmin on them safely while they're over there. And yeah, okay, so that one's taken care of. I definitely need that treasure. It's not gonna attack me unless I attack it typically. So I'm gonna be safe throwing some whites on here. And oh no! Oh, three went off the edge? Boy, they were... Restart! I wasn't paying attention. Alright, hopefully this will be the last try. Pay more attention this time, PK Gam. Pay more attention. Alright, get them all together. I want to get them all together, then separate them. That's the only way their colors will go in their proper spots to be able to whistle together easily. There we go. Alright, so flip, 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 flip. Actually, I could probably take care of them with purples as well. Flip, 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 flip. They're good, 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 good. Very good. And call them back, because they're not going to do anything while it's, flip back to its safety side, I guess you could call it, because when it's flipped on its belly, I mean, when it's in its proper position, you know, in its attacking mode, it'll be resistant to pretty much all attacks. Okay. So, no more being not careful. Okay, I'm gonna just make it throw its thing. Here we go. Get some lights on that. Okay. Where's that bomb going? Okay, so we're going way over there. That's good. As long as the bombs fly way far away from wherever there's Pikmin, I am a happy PK Gam. I can't believe this floor is the floor that's giving me trouble out of all the floors that I've had. I mean, I've been through so far. I'm gonna do this. well, that kind of works. It's not the most ideal way to take care of it, because it's not... Oh, no, no, don't knock it off the edge. Oh, no, oh, no, 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 don't fall off the edge. Oh, three fell off the edge. Oh, four fall off the edge. I just seen another one go off there. Oh, wait, wait. Actually, that one's perfectly safe there, so... If I call it back, it might fall off the edge, so I'm not going to call it back. I'm just going to leave it there and hope it doesn't fall on its own. But anyway, I'm gonna grab this bolt. Because there doesn't appear to be any, fall from the sky and destroy you types of obstacles on this floor. It just seems to be straightforward, bomb obstacles from the Dirigibugs. So, yeah. This guy's alone, so he is easy to get past. Because he's not gonna be able to zap anything. So yeah, I'm gonna take that back. And, oh, they're done. I already got the bolt back. And we already got this back before, so you already know the name of it. It is the Repair Juggernauts. Yep, 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 up. And one more on you. Oh, shoot, 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 shoot. I gotta knock it out of the sky. And also, preferably, get its bomb somewhere that is not causing Pikmin any danger. And there we go. Something new, I think. Is it? Vacuum processor. I think we're gonna be good here. Yeah, good. Oh, wait, wait, not quite good yet, huh? Okay, good. Now we're good. Okay. Yep, oh, oh, no, no, it picked up the dial. oh no, it picked up the 3G bug. Everything's getting picked up. No, they're getting to it before I can. Anode beetle. That's a pretty mean combination they got there. Try and get the poison knocked out. Okay, good. Good. Let's see here. Red means fire. Actually, I could probably grab purples and deal with this nicely as well. Because they don't have very much HP, so let's just see here. Yeah, I figured that would work quickly. Okay. Maybe that's all I'll need to do here. We're gonna see, I suppose. Just have them take those back, and I'm gonna take a look-see around here. Distract this guy. oh no. No, no, don't you dare. Don't you dare attack other colors that are vulnerable to you. Okay, we're good. Yay! Space Wave Receiver, and this floor is complete. So, where's the exit to this place? Oh, it's right next to us, that's right. Right here. So, let's go in and finish off this part. Hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you in the next part.